Good afternoon. My name is Anna Buen. As President of Student Council and on behalf of the Class of 2015, we would like to welcome you to the fifth commencement exercises of Chanhassen High School.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Madison Burke. De la part des diplômés de 2015 du lycée de Chanhassen High School, bienvenue au cinquième exercice de commencement du lycée de Chanhassen High School.
Salam, شب شما بخیر. من امیر گلبان هستم. به پنجمین جشن فارغ التحصیلان دبیرستان چنهسن های اسکول شب شما
Ettermiddag. Jeg heter Lauren Mo. På vei av avgang studentene I 2015 på Chanhassen videregående skole. Vil jeg ønske dere velkomna til den femte avslutningsseremonien på Chanhassen videregående skole.
Assalamu alaikum. Mera naam Tuba Qasir hai. Chanhassen High School ki 2015 graduates ki taraf se hum aapka Chanhassen High School ki 5th commencement taqreeb mein istiqbal karte hain.
Namaste. Mera naam Sadiksha Sanjalo. Sun 2015 class graduates ko tarfa bada Chanhassen High School ko 500 dikchanta samrahoma hajurharulai swagat gardai hu.
Xin kính chào quý vị, tôi là Võ Thảo Linh. Thay mặt cho các học sinh niên khóa 2015, chúng tôi rất vui mừng chào đón các bạn đến với buổi lễ tổng kết lần thứ 5 của trường Chanhassen.
Mabuhay, po kayong ihat, ako po si Andrew Buchanan. Inan yayahan ko po kayong lahat na manood sa aming ika limong. Taong graduation ceremony sa ngalang ang ating paraang Chanhassen High School.
Buenas tardes, mi nombre es María Valentina Contreras. En nombre de los graduando del 2015, nos gustaría darles la bienvenida a la ceremonia de graduación de la quinta promoción de bachilleres del Liceo de Chanhassen.
Kyom Chulrip Su, Chumong Kumong, Brian Hawk, Gnon Niam, Salah Chanhassen High School, Tanakti Monchup, Chanam Pi Pong Dampram, Kyom Som Swakom, Del Al Yoknyak, Del Ban Mok Chodram, Gnon Charam, Ti Pram,
Dobro veče. Moje ime je Dina Malčinović. U ime od naših diplomiranih studenata želim vam svima dobrodošlicu na peti početka Chanhassen High School 2015. Graduaciju.
Sabaidi, Kanoisu Valentina Nokeo Potisan, Yindi Thon Hap Tuktan Mahuam Nakan Chopung Hien Kong Chanhassen High School, Kapjai.
Guten Abend, ich heiße Elisabeth Raymakers. Im Namen Chanhassen High School 2015 herzlich willkommen an unserer fünfte Akademische Abschlussfeier.
Ni hao, wo jiao Jackie Schroyer. Dai biao Chanhassen Gao Zhong, 2015, nian bai ye sheng. Wo men sheng yao hon ying ni. Di wo jia bi ye dian li Chanhassen Gao Zhong.
Good afternoon. Thank you for your patience this afternoon for the delay. Did remind me a bit of Disney World when I was trying to get to Splash Mountain at the beginning coming in, but I trust that you're all comfortable now and we're gonna have a wonderful hour together celebrating the accomplishments of the students that are before us, who, by the way, look fantastic. My name is Tim Dorway and I have the honor of serving as the principal of Chanhassen High School. It's my pleasure to welcome you, members of the graduating class, District 112 staff, Superintendent Bauck, representatives of the Board of Education, parents, relatives, and friends here and joining us on the web to Chanhassen High School's fifth ever commencement exercises. Before we begin with our addresses this afternoon, I would like to first thank our student musicians and their directors for sharing their talents with us this afternoon. They are the Chanhassen High School Symphonic Winds under the direction of Mr. Paul Swanson and the Chanhassen High School Concert Choir under the direction of Ms. Sarah Gilbertson. Thank you. I would also like to take a moment to introduce those on stage with us today, and I would ask them to stand as I call their name and have them remain standing, and I would ask that you please hold your applause until all of them have been recognized. Our superintendent, Dr. Jim Bauck, our associate superintendent, Mr. Clint Christopher, our board chair, Ms. Lisa Anderson, Mr. Tim Klein, our vice chair and clerk, Ms. Josie Collarin, one of our board members, other board member Fred Berg, Ms. Heather Nelson, Ms. Amy Logue, and assistant principals Jim Swearingen and Austin Tollerson. Thank you. At this time, I will introduce Mr. Tollerson, who will be introducing our first student speaker this afternoon.
Good evening. It is my pleasure to introduce our first student speaker of the afternoon, Ms. Jenna Smithson. Jenna is the daughter of Julie and Mike Smithson and proud sister of two siblings, Tyler, who graduates today, and her sister, Bryn. While a student at Chanhassen High School, she participated in choir, our musical productions, was a member of the National Honor Society, and also performed on our dance team. Jenna is especially thankful for her two favorite teachers, Gilby and Mr. Lund, and lists going to New York with a concert choir and performing at state with dance team as two of her favorite high school memories. To her friends, Jenna is known on Instagram as Cat Lovin' Jenna, and would like to acknowledge in this introduction her favorite felines, Cola, Chico, and Mia. Next year, Ms. Smithson will attend the University of Iowa, where she plans to study theater and communication studies. Her speech today is entitled, Keep Moving Forward. Please give a warm storm welcome to Ms. Jenna Smithson.
Hard work pays off. We've all been encouraged or threatened with this phrase before. Maybe you've used it to emphasize the significance of an accomplishment. Well, I'm here today to tell you that this phrase is inaccurate. Okay, well, that's not really why I'm here, because without hard work, none of us would be here at all. But nonetheless, I'm going to tell you that hard work doesn't always pay off. I'm not trying to be a Debbie Downer on this triumphant day, but this is a lesson that all of us have learned at some point in high school. Maybe you practiced all year and still fell short of making varsity in the sport you love. Or, this one's a stretch, but maybe you studied for hours on end for a big test and still failed to get the score you wanted. And then there are those people, you know, with their glowing faces and radiant smiles that go around bragging about how hard work pays off because they worked hard and achieved their goals. So you're sitting here like, did I not work hard? Well, you have 5 episodes of your favorite TV show piled up on the DVR, and that right there is proof of how hard you worked. The only difference is no one else knows how hard you worked because you have no payoff to tweet about or Instagram a picture of. So that's it, right? You realize hard work doesn't pay off and make the decision right then and there to never work hard at anything again. If only it were that simple. But no, you get back up and pour your heart and soul into your next endeavor, accepting the very plausible possibility that your hard work just might not pay off this time either. Now, I'm up here today to represent the class of 2015, but in all honesty, how in my 5 feet and 0 inches of being could I possibly encompass the personalities, accomplishments, and dreams of all 400 graduates in this room. Each of our lives is so different, yet somehow we've all ended up in the same place at the same time. Soon, most of us will forget how to calculate an integral using a left Riemann sum. Most of us never remembered in the first place. But there are lessons we've learned that will stick with us for the rest of our lives. In sixth grade, my science teacher told our class that if we remember one thing, it should be that energy travels in waves. And he was right about the energy and that being all I remember. And there's Miss Etnier's lesson to lift as we rise, or Mrs. Gilbertson's reminder that faking it is a life skill. But then there are also the difficult lessons, the ones that make us stronger. As a member of the school's dance team, I competed a Rocky Balboa-themed dance this winter. I never thought the most important thing I'd learn in high school would come from an audio clip of Rocky Balboa in a high kick dance, but I guess that's just how life works sometimes. To quote Rocky, "It's not about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward." Now, if you've stayed awake for the duration of any high school English class, you might understand the metaphoric significance of this quote. Life is going to knock you down, and you're not always going to be able to strike back. But that doesn't mean you're defeated. Your strength lies within your ability to get up and be willing to fight again. So next time you're up, you're prepared to be knocked down, but you also know you won't stay down forever. And the beauty of it is, somewhere along the way, you won't be knocked down. And when that day comes, you can declare to the world that hard work sometimes pays off. In her book, Yes, Please, the incredible Amy Poehler shares a similar message about hard work. She writes, "You have to care about your work, but not about the result. You have to care about how good you are and how good you feel, but not about how good people think you are or how good people think you look." In middle school, I made it my goal to become valedictorian at graduation. Yes, in middle school, I was already putting crazy pressure on myself to get a 4.0 in high school. Later on, I found out our school doesn't declare valedictorian, so I figured that aiming to speak at graduation would be the next best thing. I strongly believe in the importance of setting goals and challenging yourself to be the best you can be. But there is a fine line between aiming to be your best and aiming to be the best. Knowing the difference will save you from an immense amount of stress and disappointment. Expecting yourself to be your best shows you care how good you are. Expecting yourself to be the best shows you care how good other people think you are. There's always going to be someone out there who is better than you, even if you worked harder or cared more, unless you're Oprah, of course. As long as you are dedicated to being the best you can be, it won't matter to anyone that you're not the best there is. Class of 2015. We've been pushed to our limits with AP tests, ACTs, sports, activities, and all the other challenges in our lives. We are all here today because we've proven to the world how hard we can get hit and keep moving forward. And today is our day to move forward.
The graduating class has selected Ms. Jenny Zanner Rowe as its staff speaker for this afternoon's commencement. Jenny is just wrapping up her 23rd year of service to students and parents as a public educator and her second year at Chanhassen High School. She received her bachelor's degree from McAllister College and her Juris Doctorate from the University of St. Thomas. Over the course of her career, she has most enjoyed students, teaching, geography. Before joining Chanhassen High School, Ms. Zanner Rowe also practiced law for 5 years, specializing in immigration law. One of her proudest accomplishments, however, was being named Teacher of the Year by the Minnesota City and County Administrators Association for her urban geography class at the Purpitz Center for Arts Education. Outside of her time at school, Jenny's restoring her 1917 South Minneapolis home. As many of you know, she is an avid bicyclist, and in the summer, she parks her car, especially when she is not coming to Chanhassen. Please join me today in welcoming Ms. Jenny Zanner Rowe for her address this afternoon.
Hi, kids. Thank you for choosing me to speak at your graduation. I'm deeply flattered, especially considering that it seemed like about half of you wanted me fired last year during first semester. Wasn't this the class that came marching in protest? Yes. I guess I've been rehabilitated. Thank you. What I want you to do right now, please, if you don't mind, is take a moment and think about the outstanding teachers that you've had in your academic career who are not standing up here right now. You got a name or two or maybe 10 in your head? Got it? Now what I want you to do is on the count of three, make the loudest noise that you can possibly muster. All right? One, two, three. Thank you. That was outstanding. Does that remind anybody of completing a particular major research project? Everyone here who's had me as a student, including one poor kid who's had me every single semester for 2 solid years, you know who you are, I hope. Can you imagine how many cumulative paused minutes this poor young man has endured in our documentary film experiences? Everyone here who's had me as a student knows that what I am concerned with is not your success within the walls of Chanhassen High School, but rather with your success when you leave Chanhassen High School. In other words, the extent to which you will be able to function outside in the world beyond the walls of the school. And I point it out the window every single time. Remember that? As Stephen Colbert told a bunch of college graduates 2 weeks ago, that world must look like a dark chasm of yawning uncertainty. Sounds awesome. As someone who's navigating one little part of that dark chasm along with your older siblings, your parents, your grandparents, other relatives, and everyone else for that matter, I can tell you that it is indeed awesome, particularly if you're ready to have your mind blown. And I want to tell you a story about my dad, whose name was Frank. Some of you know this story, but I want you all to know it. He died in 2008. I have him to thank for any technical facility I can claim and my true passion for the salvage yard. You, however, have him to thank for my patience with you. He went to college and graduate school in the 1960s to become a metallurgist. And for those humanities people here, that's an engineer who works with metals. He spent a couple of years in the private sector before he moved us to New Mexico for a job with the U.S. Department of Energy, creating alloys for nuclear weapons that were intended for the Soviet Union and any number of other possible countries that could get tied up in proxy wars. You've just heard a few terms that you probably don't hear at all daily. Nuclear weapons, Soviet Union. These were in the backdrop of my entire childhood. In New Mexico, particularly with a dad who worked in the defense industry, you could not escape it. I'm sure that your parents and grandparents could describe for you the default mechanism all of our brains were wired to back then. When you weren't thinking about anything else, it would be there, lurking, the destruction of the world. What a trip. The reason that you don't think about that all the time is rooted, as everything is, in geography. Yes. The Soviet Union ceased to exist in 1991, the year that I graduated from college, and the world changed forever. But that also meant that my dad's world changed forever, too. His lab in the desert was closed because we no longer needed to destroy the evil empire, and he got reassigned to the surprising task of traveling to all of the stands with public officials and scientists. In other words, he would be traveling to the very countries that he had previously contemplated destroying. Think about that. Can you possibly imagine what it must have felt like to get off that first plane in Kazakhstan? Rather than hanging on to his previous perspective, my eccentric, socially challenged, seriously intelligent father embraced the opportunity to befriend the very people for whom his bombs were meant. His entire view of the world changed because he, at the age of 58, let his mind be blown. I watched it, and I learned from it, and I think about it almost every day. What's the big shift in the world that'll change your life forever? Of course, you can't possibly know that, but you're more prepared for it than you might think. Here's how I know. This spring, towards the end of the semester, a bolt of lightning hit me, and I suddenly realized that if I put a globe on each of the tables in my classroom, it would be a good thing. You know what I'm talking about, right? I'm not talking about Google Earth. Boy, I love Google Earth. Everybody knows how much I love Google Earth. And I'm certainly not talking about your dang phones, right? What I'm talking about are these analog versions of Google Earth that are like round, right? And they sit on a stand, you know, and you can turn them, right? Okay? And what I witnessed was remarkable, and it was actually very, very moving to me. Suddenly, the first conversation that everyone had when they walked into the room was about geography, and it had absolutely nothing to do with me standing in the front of the room yelling. Immediately, the focus was on our world, and everyone wanted to talk about where they would like to live someday, and it happened over and over again every day. Nobody got tired of thinking about the future. Everyone wanted to get out there and be on our amazing planet. And every morning, you shared your dreams with each other and me. And now you get to go out there and find them. Living fully in that world I kept pointing to outside the window is not comfortable. It's uncomfortable and challenging and sometimes scary. It's failing a million times and recovering and learning. It's going to involve navigating situations that you don't understand, over which you have little or no control, and dealing with people whose perspectives you don't understand. Right? That's the dark chasm. Except I want to challenge you. Follow my dad's example, will ya? Let the world blow your mind a few times. You have no idea what'll happen, and that's fabulous. It's been an honor and a privilege to be your teacher. Edie and Buddy send you their best. Congratulations, class of 2015.
Good afternoon. I came across our next student speaker a few months ago, sitting in the commons at Chan High School, reading the Meditations of Roman Emperor philosopher Marcus Aurelius for pleasure. When I saw that, I thought, Dan Anderson is a young man worth watching. I want to know what this cat ends up doing in his life. Dan is the son of Molly and Tom Anderson, and the older brother of twin sisters Ella and Eliza. While a student at Chanhassen High School, Dan was extensively involved in the choir and theater programs and has spent a lot of his free time playing, listening to, and writing his own music. He lists Miss Laura Etnier as his favorite teacher because she genuinely cares for all of her students and strives to connect with them, as well as get every student involved in her class. A quote that is very important to Dan comes to us from Malcolm X, who stated, "I do not pretend to be a divine man, but I do believe in divine guidance, divine power, and in the fulfillment of divine prophecy. I am not educated, nor am I an expert in any particular field, but I am sincere, and my sincerity is my credentials. Next year, Dan plans to travel abroad with specific stops in Italy, France, and Germany. His speech today is entitled, The Moment of Clarity. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Dan Anderson.
Thank you so much. Hello. When was the last time you woke up to watch the sunrise? I'm not talking about setting three alarms 5 minutes apart at 6:05, and 6:10 to go take the ACT, and then just happening to catch a glimpse of the sky on your way out the door. I mean getting up for the express purpose of watching the sun peep out over the horizon. I would bet a lot of us don't even know. I would bet for a lot of us, the answer is never. The fact is, there's something extraordinary about the sunrise. It has a knack for taking your breath away if you aren't careful. It helps to center us, both literally, in that it resets our sorely damaged sleep cycles, and figuratively, in that it can put a lot of things into perspective for us. From our English classes, you may have heard of the aha moment, but personally, I prefer the term moment of clarity. The moment of clarity refers to when we suddenly understand or solve a previously complex and incomprehensible problem. An aha moment is a little more mundane, like when, after staring intently at a math test, the formula you were missing pops into your head. The moment of clarity is different, more significant, more life-altering. It's an experience that's difficult to put into words, but one that we certainly have all had at one point or another. Like the ding of a light bulb flicking on overhead, my moment of clarity came with the rising of the sun. Throughout all the craziness of high school, maybe you've felt like me, like there was some crucial piece of the puzzle that was evading your every attempt to grasp it. It's a hard feeling to explain. We don't know the identity of the thing, only that it's calling to us from somewhere beyond the small scope of Chanhassen High School. It is this thing, just out of reach, but always present in the periphery, that has brought us to where we are today. This unquenchable thirst for an indefinable thing that we know is out there is the drive that has helped us all to make it to this stage. Some of us are heading off to college to search for it, under the bottom bunk of a dorm, in a mess hall, or more likely than not, in a frat house past curfew. Some of us are looking closer to home in the employees or in the lockers of an employee lounge. Some of our searches are taking us overseas to locales breathtaking or potentially life-threatening, with a sense of courage that few possess, while others still are perhaps tired of searching and are going to wait a little while before they pick it up again. Wherever we're going, the search for this just out of reach thing goes with us. Despite all the rhetoric encouraging us to have a post-high school plan, starting from when we were too young to really think about it, I was never quite sure what I wanted to do. My next step was never really a priority for me. I couldn't possibly make such important decisions about my future at this point in time. But as my senior year began, I still had not even the slightest idea about not only what I wanted to do for the next year, but what I wanted to do with my life. All of us have found ourselves at this place at some point or another, but I imagine that few of us cut it quite so close. I felt pressure from every angle to do what everyone else wanted, and I would nod and agree to all of them. But I knew that what they wanted for me is not what I wanted for me. I was afraid of the choice. What if I choose only to find that I'm not happy after it all? What if, after all the work, all the stress, all the struggle, I realized that I chose wrong? These kind of thoughts scared me, and I felt overworked and underprepared for my future. These kind of feelings were common occurrences for me, but when we force ourselves to break out of our routines, amazing happens. As someone who's always been a bit of a night owl, that is exactly what happened to me when I decided to be an early bird one morning. I watched the sunset the day before. I was left alone with my thoughts in the quiet and the darkness all night, and on a whim, at 5:30 in the morning, I made a cup of coffee to take outside. My backyard faces due east, and inside of it is a small pond and a gorgeous and lush expanse of woods. I will never forget the way that it looked that morning. They always say that the night is darkest before the dawn, and there's a lot of truth in that. As I sat on my deck that morning, the air crisp in my nostrils, the dew glistening on the grass, the leaves swaying subtly as the gentle breeze prodded them, I sipped my cup of coffee and I watched. The beautiful hue of the twilight, that indescribable matrimony of gray and amber, it stained the sky with such a soft touch. I sat motionless and I observed it for hours. The gray began to fade into indigo, and then the indigo into robin's egg. I observed the amazing and miraculous precision with which our world worked. The sun's lifting as if levitated by a marionette overhead, the stirring and chirping of the other creatures we share our planet, rising in perfect harmony with the day. As I sat there on that morning, the most beautiful morning that I've ever known, I knew that I'd passed through the darkness and I'd reached the dawn. In high school, it's very easy to get caught in the rain. Without even noticing it, we can attract a storm cloud following over our heads. We get wet with the rain of rumors, the downpour of stress, the torrent of the drama, and before we know it, we're soaked and heavy. We get bogged down, and we can't escape it. We walk the halls drenched, and with the water in our eyes, we lose sight of the things that bring us all together. When the sun came up that morning, I finally felt dry. The simple beauty of this daily occurrence, a sunrise, caused it all to click, the moment of clarity. I can speak only for myself, but I am incredibly proud and honored to share the stage with this group of individuals. The class of 2015 is so full of so many amazing people that I feel truly lucky to have met and known. People that are incredibly talented, extremely intelligent, remarkably caring, strikingly funny, and exceptionally determined to succeed. Having known and coexisted with you all for the last 4 years, longer than that for some of you, I know with every ounce of my being that each and every person in this class is destined for great things. There are people here who I would not hesitate to say have changed my lives, and who I am certain will change the lives of countless others. There are people here who inspire me more than the larger-than-life heroes of our history books. There are people in this audience that will change the world, truly. I don't know if you've had your moment of clarity, or when you will, or what will bring it about, but I can tell you that when it happens, you will know it. It will encounter you, and you will be transfigured. Don't fret. Don't fear what is yet to come. Embrace the uncertainty. That was what came to me in my moment of clarity. Things will work out for us in the end. We have all made our decisions about the next step in our lives, and we have decisions about things yet to come. I forgot to mention, did you know what day it was when my moment of clarity came to me? May 1st, Decision Day. Decide to do great things, friends.
It's at this point that principals in high schools across the globe rattle off how much scholarship money their students have earned, where they plan to attend school next year, how many conference championships they've won, etc. Let's just summarize right now and say this. The graduating class before you has done very, very well. But more important to me and to others in this space this afternoon is that you take time to lift others along your life's path. Beside me is an example of how one person's very simple and thoughtful act can have an impact. Mr. Dwayne Clark, my high school English teacher, in March of 1989, took one moment to recognize and validate me for the work in his class. My mom, who's with us today, hi mom, wrote that message there that says, "Way to go, Tim," and left it on the kitchen table for me for when I came home from school. Mr. Clark's message read, "Thank you for the excellent ideas and questions you bring to our class discussions. It is good to see a student really care about reading and writing and express himself with such gusto. Good. It was the very first time I can recall someone beyond my family taking the time to lift me and express such confidence in my abilities. It meant everything to me, and it cost him nothing to do. As many of you know, after graduation from high school and from Winona State University, I became an English teacher. Mr. Clark was unique, a true hippie, as you might be able to tell from that photo, an author and a poet who celebrated his graduation from college by hopping on his Harley Davidson and riding across the United States and writing a book of poetry about his travels. He expressed care, compassion, and concern for his students and for others. He validated their efforts and took time to lift each and every one of us. Tragically, he passed shortly after my graduation from high school, having lost his battle with brain cancer. His book of poetry and the note that you saw are in my office as a daily reminder of the importance of lifting and caring for others. Class of 2015, you will not be judged by how smart you are, by how many awards you win, or by where you attend school. You will be judged by the content of your character and by how you show care and compassion for others. One of my heroes, Major Dick Winters of the 101st Airborne, and a recipient of the Distinguished Service Cross, said it best when he talked about leadership and caring for others in an August 2004 article in American History magazine. Major Winters said, "If you can, find that peace within yourself, that peace and quiet and confidence that you can pass on to others so that they know that you are honest and you are fair and that you will help them no matter what when the chips are down." Class of 2015, I wish you unending peace and happiness. Please take care of each other and take care of yourselves. Chair Anderson is the principal of Chanhassen High School, and on behalf of the faculty and staff who have had the privilege of working with these students, it is my honor to present to you and the school board of the schools of Eastern Carver County 385 graduates from the class of 2015 for the awarding of their diplomas. These students have successfully met all requirements as set forth by the Minnesota Department of Education and the Board of Education of Eastern Carver County Schools.
Superintendent Bauck, fellow board members, faculty, staff, and friends, on behalf of the school board of Eastern Carver County and of District 112, I am proud to accept the class of 2015 for the awarding of your diplomas. For us up here, this is what it's all about, preparing you to be your personal best and to go out into the world and do great things. From this moment forward, you will always be a graduate of Chanhassen High School. Congratulations.
In a few seconds, each student in the graduating class will be called by name to cross this stage and receive his or her diploma. It's the culmination of 13 years of education captured in one brief and very, very special moment. As I asked the class this morning during rehearsal to honor, respect, and support one another during these presentations, I ask you tonight to hold your cheering and applause until all students have been called and they have crossed the stage, and each student, first to last, has enjoyed that special moment for themselves and for their families. Readers, please bring the students forward at this time.
Samuel David Oss.
Laura Catherine Parody.
Emily Dara Edsom.
Nina Evelyn Anderson.
Shannon Lee Amberson.
Ryan Thomas Anderson.
Colin James Ambrose.
Zachary Dirk Anderson.
William Christopher Ambrose.
Jordan Rochelle Davis.
Aaliyah Marie Anderson.
Connor Jameson Dahman.
Shoal Takla Anderson.
Mitchell David Elang.
Alexandra Lee Anderson.
Samantha Taylor Pavitt.
Daniel McKinnon Anderson.
Andrew Perry Poppin.
Jordan Danielle Anderson.
Jenna Eve Smithson.
Megan Dawn Anderson.
Abraham Michael Stauber.
Thomas Scott Bush.
Puneet Aurora.
Mitchell Alton Carlson.
Andrew James Arrington.
Courtney Claire Cuff.
Grace Lorraine Arrington.
Ariana Alexis Dorschner.
Emily Ann Baker.
Emily Rose Hill.
Jack Douglas Barclay.
Megan Rebecca Langley.
Rodrigo Barrero Pujol.
Matthew Douglas Baxter.
Jackson David Bramick.
Jennifer Rose Biedling.
Kenyon Lloyd Brannon.
Claire Elizabeth Becker.
Robert Wayne Brantley III.
Catherine Paige Becker.
Nathaniel Lloyd Brenner.
Anne Marie Beecraft.
Anna Christine Buon.
Grant Robert Beery.
Andrea Jessurum Buchanan.
Joseph Peter Benson.
McKenna Rochelle Burcham.
Benjamin Christopher Berg.
Madison Faith Burke.
Jake Thomas Bever.
Christopher Terry Burns.
Sarah Elizabeth Bimberg.
Tanner Doyle Burns.
Dominic Christopher Benjili.
Trevor John Burns.
William James Bjork.
Miles Ambrose Busca.
Madison Higgins Blotz.
Mackenzie Ann Bouchart.
Kaylee Colleen Ball.
Alyssa Lynn Butler.
Ryan Douglas Boonstra.
Benjamin Michael Carlson.
Isaac Dan Boyum.
Matthew Aaron Kerjance.
Hannah Fry Christensen.
Daniel Stephen DeMarco.
Elena Ray Clegg.
Rachel Gabrielle Dodson.
Justin Douglas Clark.
James Vincent Donatio IV.
Madison Joanne Clements.
Catherine Angela Dorway.
Chad Michael Clute.
Adalia Francisca Dualen.
Andrew Glendenning Cohn Jr.
Kylie Lynn Eichelberger.
Henry James Conlin.
Kylie Ray Eklund.
Amber Joy Connolly.
Jamie Reese Elleras.
Maria Valentina Contreras.
Robert Thomas Engelking.
Amy Elizabeth Cook.
Brett Alexander Erdman.
Samantha Lynn Cost Nelson.
Elise Emmeline Erickson.
Dustin Wayne Chuel.
Samuel Richard Essie.
Kylie Joy Dahlgren.
Molly Rose Iwanaka.
Claire Julia DiBenedetto.
Carissa Ann Fahey.
Molly Claire Deegan.
Carlos Antonio Falla.
Ty William Denzer.
Joseph Anthony Ferguson.
Logan Thomas Devereaux.
Michaela Marie Fernholz.
Brock Andrew Dillon.
Ethan John Fisher.
Scott Gregory Flackney.
Corey Michael Fitch.
Dylan Riley Forseth.
Peter Bryant Greeno.
Callie Kaylin Foster.
Robert Wells Greeno.
Antonio Manuel Franceschi.
Kaya Joel Groby.
Andrew Scott Fraser.
Caitlin Jean Gunther.
Evan Robert Friede.
Alexander Olaf Harstad.
Catherine Ruby Fry.
Brandon Bradley Haas.
Logan Scott Gall.
Caitlin Freitag Hagen.
John Robert Govin.
Brian John Huck.
James Patrick Gay.
Aaron May Halla.
Nicole Marie Gerald George.
Sadie Janae Hansen.
Danielle Madeline Gitson.
Lauren Nicole Hansen.
Amir Musa Galban.
Tyler Andrew Hardick.
Alexandra Marguerite Goldwasser.
Kirk Douglas Harrington Jr.
Madison Amelia Gottschalk.
Joshua James Hartman.
Caitlin Marie Greikowski.
Sophia Marie Hartman.
Emma Marie Gronke.
Christine Lee Hastings.
Rachel Ann Grausam.
Aaron Elizabeth Hawker.
Logan David Graves.
Brooke Marie Haney.
Calvin Alexander Green.
Caitlin Ann Hesse.
Drew Richard Heyer.
Ashley Ann Hewitt.
Megan Lynn Hinsey. Victoria Louise Holman. Alyssa Holly Hong. Brooke Elizabeth Hove.
Ryan Douglas Kane.
Lindsay Eleanor Howe.
Abigail Annie Kardashian.
Griffin Paul Huff.
Bradley Michael Kefold.
Audra Lee Hurd.
Brianna Schneider Kefold.
Emily Jane Hughesby.
Sydney Ellen Kay.
Maxon Thomas Hutton.
Devin Sean Kelly.
Brett Allen Hewald.
Isaiah Jeffrey Kent Schneider.
Megan Virginia Israel.
Darby Margaret Kirsten.
Mariah Jean Jekylls.
Thomas James Kurtzman.
Shane Carl Edward Jackson.
Benjamin Kassan Kweiss.
Kirsten Lee Jacobson.
Brandon Lee King.
Dylan Matthew James.
Cole Mitchell Kirchhoff.
Julia Rose Genetto.
Allison Louise Thorson Close.
Aaliyah Whitney Johnson.
Joseph William Nackstead.
Emily Lauren Johnson.
Tyler Joseph Kabalarsik.
Nicholas Raymond Johnson.
Elizabeth Dorothy Codette.
Logan Gregory Jones.
Mitchell Lauren Kopp.
Jack Tyler Kading.
Clarissa Marie Kraft.
McKenna Rose Kaler.
Jeffrey David Kressler.
Leah Marie Kutch.
Riley Lynn Croiz.
Luke Anthony Labonte.
Martha Lee Cooter.
Brent Michael Lakoski.
Arianda Martinez Kurth.
Quinn Michael Lanners.
Patrick Militia.
Megan Marie Larinaga.
Alyssa Christine Mano.
Drew Michael Larson.
Chad James Mapes.
Charles Edward Lauerman.
Eric Matthew Mason.
Jack Henry Lavelle.
Andrew Brandt Mattern.
Adrian Marie Lee.
Jack Michael Mattson.
Kari Ann Lee.
Aaron Patricia McCormick.
Nathaniel James Willoughby Limer.
Hannah Karen McCormick.
Jordan Abraham Linus.
Matthew Ryan McGraw.
Derek Stephen Lenzen.
Trevor Michael McGuire.
Grace Nicolette Leslie.
Eileen Ann McIntyre.
Emma Diane Lose.
Emma Marie McLarnon.
Nicole Marie Lombardo.
Colin Patrick McNeil.
Beatrice Lopez Viviano.
Suzanne Elizabeth Mead.
Sydney Catherine Lura.
Robin Mackenzie Meyer.
Nicholas Paul Lydine.
Anna Alexandra Mickelson.
Grant Paul Magnuson.
Lauren Eloise Moe.
Shane Robert Mahabadi.
Jacob Daniel Moyna.
Dylan Michael Maher.
Jensen Nicole Mensch.
Adina Malchinovich.
Allie Mikhail Muffenbeyer.
Brittany Lynn Ness.
Naomi Elizabeth Moose.
Louis Huang Nguyen.
Daly Stephen Myers.
Noah Benjamin Norgren.
Jane Margaret Nelson.
Christy Alexandra Notvet.
Connor David Payette.
Lauren Christine Noyes.
Dane Alexander Peterson.
Alexis Pearl Oborski.
Carter Wayne Peterson.
Catherine Reagan O'Neill.
Hunter Warren Peterson.
Samuel Mitchell Odo.
Matthew James Pedretti.
Emily Leanne Owen.
Matilda Carol Penner.
Saber Matsko Olson.
Theodore William Pernula.
Brandon Nicholas Olson.
Angela K. Peterson.
Jeffrey Eric Olson.
Lindsay Blythe Peterson.
Michael James Olson.
Catalina Panita Pundongabong.
Nicholas Comrie Olson.
Daniel Austin Ferris.
Thomas Edward Olson.
Valentina Nokeo Podasan.
Tyler Kevin Olson.
Paige Flannery Pogue.
Maxwell Thomas Opheim.
David Anthony Pollock.
Zachary Taylor Osweiler.
Peter James Price.
Marley Ray Overgaard.
Tuba Kasser.
Matthew John De Guzman Pagolian.
Micah Robert Quast.
Craig James Parker.
Brianne Grace Riolo.
James Francis Petit.
Claire Shuesong Rasmussen.
Monica Aaron Paul.
Elizabeth Wynn Raymakers.
Maxim Curtis Polisham.
Gage Christopher Reed.
Martin Joseph Richardson.
Ryan James Reich.
Haley Nicole Risch.
Luke Daniel Remington.
Cole Michael Robertson.
Brian Jerome Hayne Reitzel.
Stephen Anton Robinson.
Sari Rose Schwimmer.
Thomas Stephen Roble.
Peter Allen Self.
McKenna Nicole Rockford.
Allie Ray Sanger.
Lino Jesus Rodriguez.
Abby Ann Shanahan.
Jack Michael Royger.
Anthony Thomas Shear.
Luke Timothy Rongich.
Jacqueline Ann Schroyer.
Sydney Ray Roper.
William Cody Silbernagel.
Derek William Rowe.
Nathan Stewart Simon.
Jack Thomas Rule.
Grant Thomas Smith.
Luis Alfredo Salas.
Neil Patrick Smith.
Sadiksa Sanjul.
Nicholas Ethan Smith.
Madison Kelly Sancher.
Sabrina Danielle Smith.
Gavin Martin Schaeferly.
Tyler James Smithson.
Nathaniel Adam Schmidt.
Austin Blake Snader.
Matthew Taylor Schneer.
Heidi Marie Snell.
Dylan Ross Schnabel.
Taylor Christine Soiney.
Jackson Thomas Schnettner.
Kesha Ann Sonnenberg.
Blake Matthew Schiff.
Caitlin Marie Sangrood.
Daniel Harrison Scholey.
Aaron Curtis Sperling.
Connor Thomas Shrimp.
Benjamin Scott Spillum.
Theodore James Schultz.
Alexander James St. Martin.
Connor Dylan Schwartz.
Anya Camille Stensrud.
Emma Danielle Swanson.
Tanner John Eugene Stolt.
Owen Maxwell Sweeney.
Bailey Renee Stoltz.
Amy Jean Swenson.
Chloe Marie Weber.
Morgan Michelle Tentis.
Madeline Renee Weibel.
Taylor Jean Tentis.
Sheridan Lee Weir.
Abby Malin Thalaker.
Megan Lee Wellner.
Sarah Rose Thorud.
Holly Nicole Werning.
Jake Lee Tierbold.
Catherine Rose Westfield.
Nicole Marie Tierbold.
Thomas John Wheeler III.
Michael Thomas Tischer.
Nicholas James White.
Mackenzie Laura Tommins.
Cole Joseph Widmar.
Elena Marie Treatheart.
Mackenzie Nicole Wilder.
Peyton Jeffrey Trich.
Haley Madeline Williams.
Jordan Mackenzie Tulinchek.
Connor Shane Wilson.
Anne Marie Rose Valentine.
Joseph Earl Wittes.
Christopher Ward Valenti.
Nicholas Kenneth Kalani Wongdok.
Lin Thao Bo.
Hunter Christian Woodward.
Jordan Lee Volk.
Thomas Daniel Workman.
Claire Antonia Vollum.
Jenna Michelle Worry.
Josie Amber Walls.
Dominic Prajaxit Zayana.
Caitlin Marie Walsh.
Rebecca May Yulitello.
Madeline Marie Walstead.
Molly Catherine Young.
Michaela Leanne Walstead.
Anna Lee Zahn.
Helena Sue Way.
Rachel Ann Zimmer. David Joseph Zadowski.
We present to you the graduated class of 2015 for Chanhassen High School. Again, we wish you the best in your life journey. We do ask that parents and guests please remain standing until all of our graduates has exited. Mr. Swanson, please begin the recessional.